Oh, welcome back, mathematicians. It's Justin again. Me and I are checking out an art exhibit called Mathematical Masterpieces here at the Miaville Art Museum. Each piece of artwork will help us learn a new math skill. Cool, right? This first painting is called Composition in Red, Blue, and Yellow by Piet Mondrian. One of the best ways to appreciate art is to slow down and notice all the little details. What catches your attention in this painting? I notice that there are a lot of straight lines, and some of them go all the way across the canvas, while others are shorter. Some of the lines cross, and some never touch. I wonder how this painting can help us learn a new math skill. Well, by the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to define and identify points and different types of lines. Have your guided notes ready, and let's explore the math behind the masterpiece. We'll be starting today with our own blank canvas. I'll draw a dot to mark an exact spot, just one spot, and call it a point. A point is an exact location represented by a dot. If you've ever seen a star in the night sky or a pushpin on a map, that's a point. A line is different. A line is a straight path that extends forever in both directions. That means if we tried to draw it completely, we'd never be able to stop. And since we can't do that, we just use little arrows to show that it never ends. But what if we don't want the line to go on forever? That's when we use a line segment. A line segment is just a piece of a line. It has two endpoints, which means it stops on both ends. Can you find an example of a line segment around you? The top of a door frame would be a line segment since it starts and stops at a specific point. Another example could be a pencil. Could we have a type of line that is a mix of a line and a line segment? Yep, we can. And it's called a ray. It's a straight path that has one endpoint and extends forever in the other direction. Imagine shining a flashlight. The beam of light is like a ray. It starts at the flashlight, but then it keeps going and going. Pause the video here and draw another example of each term we've learned so far. A point, a line segment, and a ray. Do your drawings look similar to mine? Make sure your point is just a single dot, an exact location. Now, check out your line, line segment, and ray. Remember, they're all straight paths, but their ends are what make them different. Your line should have arrows at both ends, since it extends forever. The line segment should have endpoints on both sides, because it stops. And your ray should have one endpoint and one arrow, showing that it keeps going forever in one direction. Most of the time, we need to be specific when talking about points and lines. Instead of saying that line over there, we label them with capital letters, like this, so we know exactly which one we're identifying. First, we identify a point, line segment, or ray by checking out its features. Does it have arrows, endpoints, or just a single dot? Once we identify what it is, we can label it to give it a specific name. To name a point, we call it by its letter name, like point A. Now, which points are on a line segment? Point B and point C. So, we can label the line segment as line segment BC. Notice how the little bar above BC doesn't have arrows, just like the actual line segment. Line segments will always be named after the two endpoints, like line segment BC. So, even if there are other points in the middle, we don't include those in the name. How do you think we can name this line? It runs through point D and point E, so it's called line DE. Do you notice anything different about the little bar above DE? It has arrows at both ends, just like the line it's naming. Lines can be named after any two points that are on the line, so this line could also be named line DF. When naming a ray, we always start with the endpoint and name another point in the direction it extends forever. What do you think this ray is called? Ray GH. The arrow on the bar above the letters should always point to the right like this, even if the ray itself points in another direction. So, is there a way we can describe more than one line or a set of lines? Check out these two lines. What do you notice about them? Pause the video here to record your thinking. These lines run alongside each other, but they don't ever touch. When two lines are always an equal distance from each other and never meet, we call them parallel lines, like railroad tracks or crosswalk markings. Parallel lines on a model will often have these little feathers to help you identify them. When naming parallel lines, we use this symbol that looks like two vertical bars next to each other. So this says line AB is parallel to line CD. What about this set of lines? What do you notice about where they meet or cross each other? They form a square corner where they cross, and they're called perpendicular lines, like the corner of a picture frame. If you're identifying the lines on a model, you can tell by finding this little square symbol. It means the lines are perpendicular. When naming perpendicular lines, we use this symbol, which looks like a vertical bar intersecting a horizontal bar. So this says line EF is perpendicular to line GH. But lines that cross don't always form a square corner, right? If two lines cross each other but don't form a square corner, we just call them intersecting lines, like a pair of scissors or the top of a swing set frame. So, all perpendicular lines intersect, but not all intersecting lines are perpendicular. There isn't a special symbol we use when naming intersecting lines. We just name them line JK and line LM. Can you make parallel lines with your arms? What about these lines? What kinds of lines am I showing? Intersecting. Now, what kinds of lines am I showing? Perpendicular, because of the square corner. Great! Now we could take what we've learned about points, lines, and rays, and check out that painting again. After learning about different types of lines, can you observe anything new? Maybe you're noticing some parallel lines, or that the lines in this painting are actually line segments. In your notes, create and label a few points on the various line segments so that the line segments can be named. Then, find a set of parallel line segments and a set of perpendicular line segments. Pause here to record your thinking. Since there are so many different ways to label the points and the lines in this artwork, you probably identified different lines that are parallel or perpendicular than I did. And that's great! You should have used the parallel symbol to notate your sets of parallel line segments, and the perpendicular symbol for your perpendicular line segments. Piet Mondrian wasn't just randomly painting, he was using math. Every line, every intersection, was carefully placed to create this bold design. So, what have we learned today, besides the fact that art is everywhere, even in math? Well, now you know how to find, identify, and name points, lines, line segments, and rays. You can also tell the difference between parallel, perpendicular, and intersecting lines and explain their characteristics. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice working with points, lines, and rays. And remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, every effort adds to your success. I'll see you next time! Hey, hey.